In the fight to address climate change, one of the biggest struggles we have is trying to understand actually how much emissions we're really producing. In recent years, there's been a proliferation of new technology designed to help us detect and measure carbon emissions at industrial sites. And they're incredibly useful. But actually, some of the most revolutionary data we're getting right now is coming not from instruments here on the ground, but from extremely sensitive technology running about 600 kilometers away in that direction. Satellite-based detection technology is leading to a new understanding of how much greenhouse gas we're creating on Earth. Sensors orbiting the planet are being used to find especially methane, which is about 80 times more harmful as a greenhouse gas than carbon dioxide. It's been known for a while that this kind of thing was possible, and the earliest examples were using satellite-based technology to look at the atmosphere more generally and draw conclusions about global atmospheric conditions. But what if you could look in much more detail? What if you could use this technology to examine the emissions coming from individual industrial sites? That's what one company based in Montreal decided to do.
I started with a market need. Customers realized that there was a financial risk, financial imperative for them to understand and reduce their emissions. That's when a high-quality service like ours became very interesting to them. So that was the start of it, that sort of light bulb moment of understanding that where there's a value and a price of carbon, there'll be an incentive to want to understand and reduce your own emissions. That then led to, okay, what would we need to offer as a service? What kind of performance in monitoring would customers need? And that in turn led to the design of the instrument and, frankly, the invention of a new type of instrument to be able to offer that kind of service.
Now, using this technology to detect emissions from individual industrial sites is actually quite an engineering challenge. If you imagine, these satellites are traveling at quite a rate. They're moving in free fall round orbit at 30,000 kilometers an hour. So that works out at a ground speed of about 7 kilometers every second. So you can imagine if you're trying to detect information from one specific place, you've only really got a second or two before all of that technology has flown right past. Now, GHGSat compensate for this by carefully plotting out a course of sites they're interested in along the path of the satellite and programming those satellites in advance so that they tilt as they go past. That increases the amount of time you can examine one place up into the region of something like 20 seconds.
GHGSat wanted to revolutionize the resolution at which we were making the greenhouse gas measurement, because this is, if you're going to look very precisely at a given site, this is the only way to spot the location of a leak. And this is not something that any space agency had envisioned doing in the past.
And so what that does is, you know, you take a look at this facility here. You have a huge facility which can have lots of different infrastructure, pipelines, compressors, valves, any of those can go wrong and leak. And if you want to try and send an individual with, you know, a handheld sensor, they would have to go and walk through the entire facility and check all the different locations to see if they can find a leak with their handheld sensor. What we can do instead is we can actually take an image of the entire area and say, well, actually, you've got this big leak that's coming from the top right corner. And what's interesting is that you can say, well, actually, not only are you seeing emissions from your facility, but just outside, so maybe you've got pipelines that are running underground, we're also seeing emissions that are coming out. And that's something that previous technologies weren't able to do.
What this means is that companies can actually get real data on which of their sites are producing emissions and act accordingly. And in an era where there's so many new carbon taxes and different incentives for running clean operations all around the globe, having this kind of information isn't just about sustainability, it's actual viable financial data. And it's changing the rules of the game, because in the past, the way this kind of information was gathered was by using what they call inventories. Essentially, companies looking at how much carbon a certain process makes and then scaling it up based on the numbers and arriving at a rough estimate. What we're getting now is real data, and that's a completely different story. And what we're finding in many cases is that the actual amount of carbon emissions being produced is a bit more than we were expecting.
So how are these methane emissions really measured?
The sensor technology developed and patented by GHGSat is built here at ABB's facility in Quebec City. Everything that's made here has to be rigorously engineered to withstand some of the most demanding environments possible, with no chance of any direct servicing for its entire lifetime. Emission detection depends on the specialized field of spectroscopy, measuring energy, which was pioneered by the team here back in the 1970s. Spectroscopy is based on the idea that actually every molecule absorbs light slightly differently, absorbs different frequencies of light. So by shining light on something and measuring how much light bounces back, you can draw extremely accurate conclusions about what molecules are present in that substance. So in the case of satellites, they actually use the sun as a convenient light source, and they measure how much of that light is being bounced back from the Earth.
ABB historically is a specialist in spectroscopy. We started, you know, being specialist of spectrometer back in the 70s, and we've gradually taken that technology into space and provided governments with very, very specialized instrument that would study the whole spectrum, like all the colors, we could see all the gases and so on. Now, companies like GHGSat sort of build up on this general know-how and say, I want to observe methane or CO2 at a very fine level, and then they say, okay, we're going to observe in this region. Then you can design an instrument from that knowledge base that is optimized to give you the most rapid information as you're flying over a site and extract that.
And for climate science, this new technology is opening up new possibilities for governments as well as private firms. Japan, NASA, the Canadian Space Agency, and the European Space Agency are all operating climate satellites, many depending on ABB measurement and analytics technology. As industries and communities look harder and harder at how to deal with their emissions, the basic principle remains the same. To deal with something, first you have to measure it. And thanks to the cutting-edge technology coming out of sites like that ABB plant, space science looks set to play a crucial role in how we address climate change.